Hey there guys, this is Ignite the Fire, and welcome back to another episode of my Skyrim Sparrow Adventure Let's Play for Nintendo Wii. This is episode number 12, so naturally in this episode we are going to complete chapter 12, known as Troll Warehouse, to 100%, so without further ado, let's get right into the level here. Okay, we are entering Troll Warehouse, one of my favourite levels of the game. I love all of the tech areas, actually. They're all really, really fun and creative. I also love the fact that levels from, like, way back from level 1, NPCs that were in that level are reintroduced in these levels. That's awesome. Funny how it actually took me 3 attempts in that sentence to get it right, but hey-ho, who really cares, right? Nope, I recognize you just fine. Scratch that, there's very few levels in the franchise that are bad, period. Either way, we've got Troll the Rune here. Oh, I love that name.
Hey, wait for me.
And actually, that reminds me of Logan, and I tell you what, that movie is a blooming masterpiece. I love that movie. I mean, like, Logan is about as close to perfect as any comic book movie can get, and I surely hope that it wins an Oscar. Logan deserves it, man. Deserves it. But then again, I say I hope it gets an Oscar. I don't actually ever watch the Oscars. I think the Oscars are the biggest piece of junk going. Especially since their animated movies department for the last few years has been utter rubbish for the most part. Yeah, I just don't find them any joy in, like, watching them or hearing about them or stuff, you know. I mean, of course, it is a great honour to be nominated for an award, and an even greater honour to actually win it, but, still, you catch my drift. And it's a shame that, like, the Oscars kind of separate good films from bad films, and they're like, oh, this film didn't get an Oscar, you know, since it's not as good as this one, even though that might not be the case. That the only troll character in the whole of the franchise actually has the word boom in his name. So, yeah, that story score is about the most correct story score in, like, the entire of the franchise, period. Okay, so that treasure chest right there, there is an easy way to get through it. You can go through it by walking through the mines, but there is a much easier way which doesn't get you as damaged, and I'm going to show you that later. I won't exactly call the Golden Gear junk, dude. doesn't look like junk now, does it? Life zone coming right up, and this life zone you basically have to go through twice in order to unlock all of the secrets. So what I'm hoping to do is when it comes to a speedrun, I'm hoping to be able to go through this area fast enough to get it done. And, like, it's not a very long area, and like the level that I would gain from going through the level normally should be enough to like warrant me taking this extra route. Especially when it comes to who is doing the speedrun, because she'll be able to absolutely rocket through this section and the rest of the level. So basically what I'm saying is that I'm hoping for the speedrun that all the spare time that will be left will be able to be used wisely in getting the getting this level completed, this part of the level completed to 100%. And as for the speedrunner, it's probably no secret because it must be a life and it must be a girl. And what other life girl is there in the life element than Stillforth, right? So yeah, I did spoil for surprise, but I meant to spoil it, so you know. It might be a fail, but it's an intentional fail, so it's not as bad as a fail as a fail. Okay, we have more puzzles right there. Yeah, fortunately these puzzles aren't too hard, but there are some puzzles that do get very difficult later on in the series. Okay, here we go, this is looking good. I think I've cleared the level at this point. Yep, I've got it. So, yay me. I'm currently on half term, so I basically have a week break of school. And so I've been using my time very productively, as I call it. And by productively, I mean watching all the movies I can. So yeah, I've recently managed to get through the Pirates of the Caribbean, the first four movies. Haven't seen the new one in cinemas yet. And let me tell you, that series gets worse and worse the later on in the franchise it is. Anyway, we're going to get the hat over here first because it takes more keys to unlock it, so it'll take longer in the zone later to actually get the hat. So we're leaving the legendary treasure for later because that'll be easier to snag, but still fail. Do I want to wear the hat? No, I don't, because I got my awesome top hat on. But either way, we're going to swap from Zook here and swap to Ghost Roaster so I can show you the way of getting that treasure chest with taking much less damage than what you normally would by doing it. And then I've also watched, in terms of movies, I watched a ton of stuff on Netflix. Like, I just got through Chappie, and I actually really enjoyed that. Like, it was very, the story itself was very nicely structured, and it's just a great movie in general. Either way, as getting through this, relatively unharmed, we simply needed to use Ghost Roaster's invincibility move and Blammer, because you know he's invincible drawing that. Of course he does take some damage, but it's so little, he only takes like 7 damage every few seconds, and that's way less than the mines, which of course deal 80 damage each. Oh, don't. Yeah, Ghost Roaster is very, very good. I like Ghost Roaster quite a lot. I think he's a fan favourite as well, so that's what makes him way more memorable than the Forgotten Eight. We still refer to him to the Forgotten Eight, so you know what characters we're actually on about, even though, like, most of them are forgotten at this point. It's only Sunburn, which is why Sunburn is the Forgotten One. And then when it comes to Giants, the Forgotten One is Fright Rider. When we're talking about the course, we talk about the Giants, and technically they're for Forgotten Eight, but really the Giants are more memorable because you know they were the gimmick ones. But I personally find that the only ever gimmick character that was actually actually a Trapmaster by the name of Thunderbolt, because Thunderbolt, his design, like, reminds me of Wildstorm, which basically took the Thunderbolt's design and improved upon it to make it much better. And so, because whenever I come to recall the characters, whenever I think of that guy, he just makes me think of another character, makes me forget about that guy altogether. Okay, we have little buttons here to push. I accidentally skipped that, so I apologize about that. Like I said in my previous episode, it's sometimes hard to get out of old habits, but you didn't really miss anything. I mean, like, all I did was open up gates and stuff. Okay, water, so I'm going to swap to that. Yeah, when I come to actually redoing this game, when I get a capture card, I'm going to do it on the Xbox 360 version, because that's the dominant port of this game. Even though it does have more glitches, but it's still better in terms of graphics and pacing, because characters actually move a little bit quicker in the Xbox and PS3 versions, just in case you guys haven't noticed it. But hey, you guys can notice all of the cool stuff now that you've got the expert in the book. There is a little gold over there, but I'm not going to bother going for it because it's absolutely maxed out. Yeah, like I said, most of my characters are because of how often I play these games. Actually, come to think of it, the video games I've been playing this half term as well have been in the form of, like, I've played The Last of Us, Metro Last Light, and I've also gone through Skylar's Trap Team again, like the bazillionth time, because I love Death Game. I love pretty much all the games in this franchise. The worst one is the Superchargers, but even Superchargers is good. Or at least half of it, anyway. In case you guys didn't get that, I was referencing the vehicles being the bad half of the game. Which is such a huge shame, for vehicle sections were not as boring as they were, as in they weren't point A to point B, and as in they were side quests only and they weren't forced upon you, then that game would have easily been the best in the franchise. But because they are forced upon you and because they are boring, then the most important thing about a game is the gameplay, and when only half of your gameplay is good, that means that the game cannot be as good as the other ones in the franchise that have like 75% of the gameplay being good. Okay, this puzzle is very much completed right now. Another thing I've been doing is I've been going back to the old seasons with Walking Dead to watch it with Ed. And we both actually really like Walking Dead. But when it comes to the Walking Dead, my least favourite seasons is actually Season 2 and Season 7. I don't actually enjoy Season 7 that much. I mean, like, Season 7 had lots of really, really good episodes, but then it had a lot of really, really bad episodes. But the biggest problem with Season 7 was the pacing, in all fairness. Okay, we have a treasure chest right here to worry about. But, you know, no moan here. But that's my favourite season of The Walking Dead, easily Season 6. I think in Season 6 there was about 2 bad episodes. And that's only my personal opinion as well. Season 6 and Season 3 were definitely the best seasons. Who knows, maybe it's just that the best seasons will always be multiples of 3, so 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, if they get to that many. Which, they're aiming for 20 seasons, but they might make it, but I don't think they will. Especially not if, like, the ratings drop as low as they did in Season 7. Okay, so as for who we're using for this Firegate right here, it's none other than Series 2 Eruptor. Who was the second to last Series 2 I ever got? The last Series 2 that I got from Giants was Drobot, because Series 2 Drobot is a blooming pain to find. Because he was released in very limited quantities in America only, and because I live in Europe, basically what I'm saying is that he was never released in Europe. And so I had to get him shipped in from America, which was expensive. Like, seriously, most of the price I paid for Drobot was from the shipping. Like, Series 2 Drobot actually only cost me £2 himself, but the postage cost me, like, £15. But at least they got him, and that's what matters. And he's an awesome addition to the collection, especially with how well his post is executed. But we're not going to get into look too much detail about that, because I have other videos detailing that, so there's no need to repeat myself. But you can also argue that there's no need to, like, try and publicize myself either. I just realized I'm already struggling coming up with things to say, and I got like two more of these to go yet after this, so I better hurry up and like find stuff. Oh man, I messed that up. Yeah, I'm just trying to recall how to do this puzzle now. I think this is one of the harder puzzles in the game. Oh, never mind, I got it. Yeah, I've just been stupid. Trust me guys, I'm not normally this stupid, I'm just stupid when it comes to games sometimes. And that's why I hate puzzle games, because games I basically just want to play to switch my brain off. I don't want to play them just to make my brain hurt even more. Okay, we got the rocket hat, which looks awesome, so of course we're gonna wear it, man. It reminds me of Toys to Bob. Toys 2 Bob, what am I saying? Toys 4 Bob. Who is the developer of Imaginators, Trap Team, Giants, and Spyro's Adventure, aka the four better games in the franchise? Nudge. But yeah, Vicarious Visions don't work on Skylanders anymore. They work on other stuff, which I can't remember names off the top of my head, so I'm not gonna say anything so I don't make anyone mad or anything. Even though I'm probably making people mad by not remembering names anyway, but I don't want to make them even more mad by recalling the wrong names, because recalling the wrong names is even worse than not recalling any names whatsoever. But when it comes to the names of Skylanders, you'll never find me wrong in that category, you can trust me on that. Okay, we're going to approach through this minefield here. I would say we've got to approach through it carefully, but nah, we really don't. I could get through this minefield without the map, but what this game does is for programming means that you can't actually take the path until after you collect all pieces of the map. And you can't just go through it with Ghost Rose's invincibility, because you actually need Snuckles to follow you to trigger that ending cutscene right there, which I skipped through by accident, so I'm not going to skip that when we come to the speedrun here. But you really have a cutscene right after I press A to continue, so let's get straight into that stuff. But yeah, I like the programming of the level, not allowing the mines to like clear until after you've collected the map. That's clever.
Do you see that thing?
from Star Wars Episode 3, but I'm really bad at it, so I'm going to save your ears from the pleasure of me doing that. You're welcome, guys. Trust me, you'll be glad if you actually heard it. You'll be like, yeah, I really wish you didn't do that. Anyway, we're going to head straight back on into the level here. And let's hope that we can successfully collect the legendary treasure while doing the speedrun as well. Maybe it can be just like the level from Chapter 6, which is actually half as well, so you know, maybe if a multiple of 6s will be in for the completing speed goals and getting the last collectibles in the Elemental Gates Syndrome. You know, hopefully both the all multiples of 6 for levels from those ones will be alright with that, if you guys get what I'm saying here. Which you probably know, because it's me, but hey, that's me, and I'm starring. Chauvin again?
Hey! Wait for me!
Thanks for that, Snuggles. I hate it when people interrupt my gameplay like that. It's not cool. Okay, now, will you die already? Okay, time for you to die. Okay, nice, let's keep going. Never retreat, never surrender. That's awesome, a great feel, by the way. Highly recommend that one. As well as Never Back Down as well. If you're gonna watch Never Back Down, watch the director's cut version. Because it's got a lot of extra stuff in there. As in, like, for action scenes are way longer and have a lot more, like, brutal moves in it. And so, of course, that automatically makes it a more dominant version to watch over the regular version. Because basically, when they came to making Never Back Down, they wanted to pander towards a teenage audience. But originally, the fights were too long and too brutal for the movie to have a teen rating, and so they had to dial a few fights down for the theatrical release. But then when the DVD came out, of course, they got the director's cut edition, which is the one on Netflix. So yeah, Netflix is highly worth it. I mean, £6 a month for all of the TV shows and movies you get, there's not one service that you get more value from than Netflix, and I can guarantee that much. Like, I honestly could not live without Netflix. Netflix is life, bruh. Okay, we're gonna collect both these keys right here. If you have, like, extra keys from this level and bring them out of the elemental gate, there's no point in doing that because, you don't, like, gain anything extra from it. There's nothing actually, no other gates to actually unlock outside of the elemental challenge. Would have been interested if they did that though, like maybe the legendary treasure should have been in a locked gate outside of the elemental zone. That would have been an interesting puzzle. Okay, we have these guys to defeat before we can advance, which we got done very, very quickly right there. And it also did help that we had, of course, the help from the life element of the zone. Okay, we're gonna complete this puzzle right here as well. Luckily, when you come into the puzzles, it doesn't actually affect the timer. So yeah, if you take forever from the puzzles, that don't matter towards the speedrun. Because the time in these puzzles does not count towards the overall timer for it. Yeah, basically, the program for this game would have like a little timer on the screen, but the only thing is that it would be hidden, so you wouldn't actually see it. And then, if the timer is less than the what the objective calls for, then basically the objective will be ticked off. That's how programming works. And trust me, I know because I take computing. That one, then we gotta go around and push this one forward twice actually. Darn, my battery for battery on my phone is running low now. First the gamepad, now the phone. Honestly, I can't catch a break in these videos. Either way, there's the third piece of the map, and we're just gonna run straight on through to the puzzle right here because we got no need to worry about them enemies right now. Thank you. use gravity to your advantage here. Actually, you've also got to use gravity to your advantage in boxing as well, now that I come to think of it. Gravity and momentum are basically the key things towards being a good boxer. Like, if you can shift your momentum, then you can get great power in your punches. And also, you need to be great at blending offense and defense for it as well. Because, you know, you've got to be good at being offensive, or else you're never going to knock anyone out. But you got to be good at being defensive, or else you'll be knocked out, you know. Simple knowledge, peoples. Not that you guys didn't know that, of course. Because if you are smart, well done for being smart. I congratulate you. And if you're dumb, I hope you succeed in life anyway. Even though that might have been mean, but really, I don't really care. I mean, I try to be inspirational, but most of the time, I bet I ain't too inspirational. Who knows? I might be. But if I've inspired, like, one person, then, my goal is complete. The whole of my life goal is complete if I literally just inspire one person over YouTube. So, done. If I inspired you, please put it in comments. If you was to put that in comments, then, boom, life goal is achieved. I'm happy. Okay, there we go. We managed to boomify the level. And I fortunately did not skip a cutscene that time. And I even managed to get the speedrun, so that's great. I managed to complete the speedrun and do the elemental challenges. So it appears that all chapters that are in Inner Force of 6 are fine with us doing the speedrun and getting the last collection in the elemental gate at the same time here. That's why I love multiples of 3s and 6s, especially since multiples of 3s are in multiples of 6s as well. Because, you know, maths. But either way, here's the video done. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next one. Peace.